here. It's day 7 of week 5 of 52 weeks of vlogging, and it's Oscar night! When we think of the Oscars, we tend to think of all the glitz and glamour that people associate with Hollywood. The red carpet, the glamorous couture dresses, the ginormous diamond necklaces, the one Gloria Stewart wore on the red carpet in 1998 after her nomination for her role in the film Titanic was worth a whopping $20 million. The people who love fashion fall all over themselves to first swoon over and then imitate the fashions on the red carpet. And the people who hate that kind of thing and think it's a waste of time and money and resources tend to despise it and, by association, everything else that Hollywood creates. Unless that thing is a movie by James Cameron about a bunch of blue people, in which case we loved it about $2.78 billion worth. Which is more than the GDPs of 35 different countries and 7 territories and dependencies. Including Greenland, the British Virgin Islands, Liberia, and Somalia. And if you add his other movie about a big boat that sank, then his films gross more than the GDPs of Suriname and the Cayman Islands. I think it's pretty safe to say that regardless of critics' opinions, the world at large thinks very highly of James Cameron's work. So, the Oscars are kind of the epitome of the culture of excess, and even though there are some great examples of using that excess to do good things, like when Uggie's collar got auctioned off for charity, or when Elizabeth Taylor sold the whopping 69-carat diamond pendant necklace she wore to the 1970 Oscars, and then used that cool $3 million she got for it to build a school in Botswana. The Oscars still have a long way to go before anyone can say that the excess is justified. But here's the thing. Most of those dresses and jewels that those famous actresses are wearing are borrowed from the people who designed them. Ronald Winston, the chairman of the jewelry company Harry Winston, famously had a silent panic attack when he saw Madonna take one of the earrings she'd borrowed from him in 1991 and fling it into the crowd during her Oscar night performance. It all worked out well in the end. She'd switched out the real earrings for fake ones before her performance, so Mr. Winston got his diamonds back. And the same pieces get reused over and over again. One interviewer even recognized the diamond earrings she had worn to her own wedding in the ears of the actress she was interviewing. And that shiny gold statuette that everyone always says is so heavy? 8.5 pounds of tin, with some antimony and copper thrown in, covered in a gold-plated coating. So let's recognize the Oscars for what it really is. A place for professionals in film and television to recognize excellence in their field. In the only way they can, by putting on a show. A glitzy show with too much emphasis on facts and in excess, to be sure, but a show nonetheless. And those couture dresses and ginormous diamonds? Nothing but costumes. Out for an evening and then back on the rack waiting for the next actor or actress to come and put them on. And they don't mind that they're wearing borrowed clothes or that the statuette is mostly tin, because the clothes and the statuette and the jewels are not what's important here. What's really important is that these people are being recognized this evening for being the very best at what they do. So let's let them have their evening. Let's let them dress up. Because if you were going to be up there, you'd want to dress up too. Thanks for watching. I'll see you tomorrow.